Please comment on the conscious fear of death as run in our lack of ability to accept the dying. Thank you. I think that the non-acceptance of our own death and of the experience of the seeing dying people is a neurotic symptom which is goes together with the whole neurosis of our civilization. It is a lack of instinct. The only thing which can help us to face death and to face the death of others are the instinctual reactions. I have had, unfortunately, to analyze quite a lot of people who were doomed to die, had a severe cancer, and from the dreams, there was no possibility to accept a miracle healing, and therefore the dreamer and I agreed on that now in about 6 months or a year, this would be the end, and sometimes quite younger people, which is a very tragic thing. And one of the most, the process of individuation goes on in these people exactly as if death would not happen. It just goes on in a rather greater pressure speed. They mature faster. And death is practically in a lot of dreams ignored. I saw only brutal death dreams in cases where the people hadn't yet accepted death and against all hope still hoped, and by that wasted time. Then they had brutal dreams like their watch standing still, their life tree being cut down. Just dreams we say, no, you must face the fact now that that's going to be the end. As soon as people accepted the fact and faced it, then there was no more such dreams. But then, on the contrary, one of the most frequent dreams I have seen in dying people, with all the different individual other variations, is that they should trust the animal. That a dog, their horse, their dog, or some animal would lead them through the dark door. Which shows that we have, that nature has built in us an instinct. I think the instinct to live and the instinct to die is the same instinct. That same nature which carries us in the right way through life is that same nature which carries us on through the gates of death, and we have to trust it. So it's only if we are clinging to our conscious views and not trusting the depth of our psyche that we are afraid of death. Naturally, the ego likes to live and makes a lot of antics and doesn't go. That also belongs. But deeper down, there is a slow stream which prefers for death. And there are sometimes, in before death, those people have such incredibly comforting and beautiful dreams that it takes away not the whole tragedy of death, but quite a bit of it. I would like to tell you, for instance, one dream which has stuck in my memory forever, though it was not an experience with a patient of myself. It was a patient, a young woman who got cancer, which did, finally the metastasis went into the brain, and she was partly delirious. And her analyst, who is a friend of mine, visited her towards the end every day and talked to her, because she still sometimes was there, and he tried to comfort her as well as he could. And the last dream, exactly 24 hours before she died, was that she was standing beside her bed in her nightgown, feeling wonderful. She naturally felt absolutely rotten in this last phase of her dying process. And the doctors came in and said, yes, against all expectations, you are cured. You can now put your clothes on and leave the hospital. And she happily reached out for her clothes and said, I'm cured. And then she looked back and saw in the bed herself lying as a corpse. You see, I think one couldn't say clearer. In one way, you will die, but in another way, that will be your psyche. You go on living, and you will even feel better and good again and be cured and be able to go on. But your body is gone. That is the simplest death dream I have seen, I mean, which puts it in a nutshell. But there are many more dreams, and mystical and very strange dreams about death, which, if one attends to them, the process of dying is very much mitigated. And generally, people who are closely struck by the death of somebody they love in their surrounding have also comforting dreams, if they attend them. So I think that we are so terrified of death is partly because we are cut off from nature.